love space. Who here thinks that an asteroid could come along any day now and wipe us all out? That's what I thought. When most people hear asteroid, they think only one thing. Are we doomed? All of the science be damned, we want to know if we're going to go the way of the dinosaur. And the answer to that is probably not. But we do have a complicated history, and I kind of wanted to share that with you today. You might be familiar with Meteor Crater. It was made by an asteroid no larger than that tiny white dot in the center. And it was able to do this because it was going 8 miles a second. You might think that's impressive, but that's nothing. In Siberia, there was a meteor that blew up in the air. It was so powerful that it felt like an earthquake on the ground. And it knocked out an area of forest the size of North Phoenix. But still, we can do better. This one from a few years ago streaked across the sky, and it was so intense that it actually was brighter than the sun for 50 miles around. People on the ground felt the heat from it. Now, I know you're sitting there probably thinking, Andrew, I don't feel much better about this. But that's okay. Space is vast. And the fact is that most asteroids just pass us on by. The most dangerous encounter we're going to have is in 2175. So we're safe for now. If you're wondering what an asteroid is, it's simply a rock that's orbiting around the sun. And when they come into Earth's atmosphere, they're known as meteors. And the ones that crash land are known as meteorites. Now, that one is a 31-ton meteorite at a museum in New York. I was lucky enough to see it. And you might think that's impressive, but that's not as large as they can get. They range from the size of small cars to large states. So we're very lucky that space is as vast as it is. Now, there's a lot of wondrous things out there in space. And the planets and the moons, they get a lot of the attention, a lot of the press. But asteroids are cool too, and they're actually going to help us out in a big way. They're the key to unlocking solar system travel. And here's how. The Earth, taking a pound of material from the Earth up to orbit, costs $10,000. Why would you do that when you have all the material you could ever want up in space? So the idea is that these asteroids are now the new gold mines, and we're on the cusp of a new gold rush. And the first step is to go prospecting. We can use these tiny cameras, some no larger than a shoebox, in orbit around the Earth to find the right targets. And once we get there, we can use a variety of ways to capture the material. This is actually one that I came up with. It's a bucket wheel, and it's designed to scoop material right off the surface of an asteroid. But however we grab it, once we have that metal, we've proven that we can 3D print structures out of meteorite metal. We can actually do this. So, once we have that asteroid material, we can make whatever we want in space. The only problem that remains is, we have the structure, how do we get around? Well, asteroids can solve that problem too. They have ice within them, and by baking that out, you can actually get steam that you can use as propellant around the solar system. So you can think of them as interstellar gas stations. I've told you all of this, and you're probably sitting there thinking, fantastic, when can we get started? When can we go there? And the problem is that it's not that simple. You have to take baby steps. It's very hard to find the right kind of asteroid. It's even harder to get there, and it's almost impossible to go and grab a piece. But that's what I love about this field, what I love about asteroids, and what I love about space engineering. They're going to give us an impossible task, and we say, okay, let's do it. And I think there's a lot of power in that. There's a lot of power in human ingenuity, in our efforts to take an idea, to take our imagination and turn it into metal and electronics and reality. And the truth is, if we can make a robot, send it 100 million miles out into space, grab a piece of this rock, and then bring it 100 million miles home, then I think that we as a species can do anything. Thank you.